I just have a brief story to tell that I think should cover pretty much all I have to say. Most of you probably don't know that Jessica was born with a slight little defect. It's called a mitral valve prolapse. And what that means is that she had a little hole in her heart. So she got her heart repaired, and that allowed her to begin to fill that hole in her heart. And the first way she came about filling her hole in her heart was she had her two children, Jake and Jeremy. And the hole started to get filled up. Then, through circumstances, she became much, much closer with her two sisters, Christina and Julia. And again, the hole in her heart became more filled. But today, seeing Vince and Jessica up at the altar, I know for a fact that the hole now is completely filled.
When I was on the phone with her one day, and she said, well, there's this guy, Vince, and oh, I really like him, and, you know, he's just so great. And so I, of course, wanted to know everything about him, you know, but he's wonderful and really, really cares about my sister. And I think, you know, the first time I met him, that was very obvious and apparent, and just seeing her so happy, and he really is such a gentleman, treats her like gold, so... Yeah, I think even just that she told me at all, she knew early on that he was the one.
You know, she makes him a better person. And without knowing her as well as I would really like to, I love her for that. I love her for the fact that she makes one of my best friends in the whole world better. And I'm just so glad they found each other.
Now today is a very special day. It's a day that you'll cherish and hold dear to your hearts for many, many years. It's your wedding day, and in the years to come, it's your anniversary. It's something that's supposed to be celebrated each year on this very day. It's a reminder of how far you both have come as a married couple. How much you've accomplished together. And just how much more happiness lies ahead.
It's just a really exciting time to see your sister so happy and excited about the day. She hasn't been stressed at all. She's just super excited and living it and enjoying it. So it's been really beautiful to watch.
Awesome ladies.
Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah.
This is why you are so awesome.
Just really happy that she finally met someone that she deserves, that treats her well and is good to her. Makes me happy. So I'm just really glad that she's met someone like that.
It's awesome going to church
with me. Aww. Looking good, Ice.
Does this look good?
Yeah, that's great.
Nice.
I'm glad you weren't at the Ivory, too.
Does Ivory look good?
Yeah.
Ivory mom, good?
Ivory, awesome.
Yeah. Yes?
Definitely Ivory.
Yeah, okay, cool. Yeah.
Wonderful. It should happen before you get your makeup.
Yeah.
Can't wait to see how stunningly beautiful you look in your dress. I can't wait to see you in a while. And now I don't have to wait any longer to go at the altar.
For my love, Vincente.
God. Wow.
Wow.
My mom is the best person I know. She works hard for everything she wants.
Work hard and good things will come. And this is definitely proving that she's worked hard all her life. And she's successful and she's getting married. So, couldn't ask for anything better.
My mother came over to him and she held his face and said, "Vincent, you're going to be such an incredible husband." And he starts getting pretty emotional, starts, tearing up. And it's beautiful because they're not tears of being afraid. They're not tears of being nervous. They're tears of happiness and understanding that today is the day that I am professing my love to the woman that I want to be with for the rest of my life.
You're an amazing person. Warm, patient, caring, tolerant, smart, handsome, open, honest, loving, fun, hardworking, and easygoing, to name just a few wonderful qualities you have. So you deserve the best, and I want you to be the best for you. The best wife ever. That's what I want. Mrs. Vincente Di Pietro, I can't wait. See you at the altar.
So this is not just an ordinary wedding. This is a commitment. This is faith. This is purpose that's holy and sacred and joyful. God, you've given it all to us for a purpose.
Six on the second hand to New Year's resolutions. And there's just no question what this man should do. Take all the time lost, all the days that I cost. Take what I took and give it back to you. All this time we were waiting for each other.
We are here on a very special occasion for the joining of two wonderful creations of God. And what created them so wonderful was God's love. And that's why they are, as we see them now, so wonderful in love.
I think I will always remember Jessica seated on the altar. I love Jessica, and I've had many good times with Jessica. And I have just never seen her with that smile on her face, with that happiness, that complete, utter, glowing, unconditional happiness.
I, Vincente, take you, Jessica, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and I will honor you all the days of my life.
I, Jessica,
take you, Vincente,
to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
My dear friends, brothers and sisters, I present to you now Mr. and Mrs. Vincente and Jessica Di Pietro.
You can see the way they look at each other, how much they really truly love each other and really respect each other, which is, I think, so important.
They're both really intense people, and I think the same thing goes for the relationship. They are intensely dedicated to each other.
I think more than anything, they're just like great companions. And I think from that companionship, from that friendship, grew their love. And I think that that's what makes the love that they have enduring.
how does it feel to have an honor?
It's, yeah, dude, I want people to know, like, I'm taking it.
He's somebody that, you know, I sort of model myself after. He's just a kind, you know, genuine, wholehearted person.
He's literally taken life by the reins and made it his.
Ring through the sky like a bicycle bell. Light up the stars with the stories we tell. We're all smiles, we're all smiles, we're all smiles.
When me and my brother met Vince, we thought he was the corniest guy ever. I mean, goodness.
But having Vince like around for a couple years, I mean, the nicest guy that you could ask for to be your new stepdad. And we love him. Couldn't ask for anyone else to make my mom happy.
You know, the first thing we think when we hear Jess is like, Vince, she's awesome, we love her, don't screw it up.
Such fun, darling, you. Oh, 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 oh. You're the only one who can take me home. I never know it could be such fun, darling, you. You really know how to shake me.
I knew right away that she was not somebody that was a low-key person. She was willing to open up to a family that I think that she thought that she could grow old with and be a part of. And that meant a lot to me. And I'm really happy she's my sister.
Mr. and Mrs. Vincente and Jessica DiPietro.
It's the nightlife calling. Can you hear it?
We're so happy that you're here. Earlier, we were just looking out in the crowd, and we said this is the exact size of people that we wanted at our wedding for our most special day of our lives. So I thank you all for being here this evening, and I hope you leave everything on the dance floor. And I mean that sincerely. I hope I can all count on you for that.
We're all having a great time partying with all the people that are important to us. It's monumental is I think the word is.
It's just fun seeing everybody out there, all family, just enjoying themselves. Because, you know, I feel like in life we're just so caught up in what we're doing, and we never really get a lot of chances to sort of be together. And these are the chances that, you know, quite honestly, I come here and I take full advantage of, and, you know, bring us together and sort of reiterate, you know, a lot of things like love and things of that nature, especially in the fact that it's, you know, it's a wedding.
So, Vince, I'd like to officially welcome you to our crazy family. I'm beyond lucky to be gaining such a wonderful brother. So I ask that everyone raise their glass. Toast, Jessica and Vince. Here's to many years of love, laughter, and happiness. I love you both.
I remember looking at Jessica and just thinking how incredibly happy she is and how hard that she worked for a day like this and how incredibly proud I am to share this day with her, because it's been a really long time coming.
So I'd like to propose a toast to Vince and Jessica and all the special F words. And they are to friends, family, fate, forgiveness, and forever. Cheers, Vince and Jessica. Congratulations.
I wanted to also just give two final thanks. One to my future stepsons for allowing me to take your
I don't see my brother choke up a lot, but when I saw that and him thanking them, it was such a beautiful moment.
For allowing me to take your mother's hand in marriage, it's an honor, it's a privilege, and I'm humbled to be a father figure in your lives. And if you need me for anything, I mean that, so long as it doesn't get me in trouble with your mother.
Absolutely, hands down, one of the best moments of this wedding.
I love my mom, I love my brother, and I would do anything for them. I would take a bullet for them. I would trade all the money in the world to spend one more second with both of them. I mean, they're just worth more than anything in this world to me, and that's what I think love is.
An amazing character, he really is. He's dedicated, he's industrious, he's loving, just a wonderful, wonderful son.
I'll always remember from this wedding, just dancing with her, holding her, and hearing from her that she was just absolutely happy.
Jessica and Vince are very in love with each other, and they exemplify the definition of love.
We got engaged here just right back in November, and we've spent the last 5 months planning on steroids for this beautiful wedding. And we've been through ups and downs. We've learned a lot about each other. And I just want to thank you for putting up with me. And I want to thank you for just being a fantastic future wife. The last 3 years, as you know, I've been packing my suitcase, coming to your place every weekend. And I'm so happy now to unpack my suitcase and never have to pack it again, because now I have a home and I'm so excited for my new family and what God has in store for us. Thank you, I love you.
They're partners in crime together and they're great together. You know, I think they have nothing but the best of everything to look forward to.
I know that they will get through the hard times and really relish the good times. I wish nothing but the best.
See lots of wonderful years together, growing and even coming closer together.
My wish would be that they would always feel the same way that they felt today when they look in each other's eyes, you know? That they always remember the joy that they bring each other and that they continue to bring that joy to themselves and then each other.
I can't wait to remind you how truly proud I am of you and how far you've come in life. I can't wait to always be up your ass.
Give me like a sexy girl. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, good.
rising from dust, watching as the night burns through us, walking through the clouds of what was. We are alive, we are alive, yeah. Sun in our eyes.